Brought to you by
Eaton Detroit Spring, proudly made in the USA.
Also brought to you by BF Goodrich Tires, who asks, are you driver enough?
This week on Autorestomod, Jeff tackles how to take outside mirrors apart and how to put them back together.
National Parts Depot is proud to offer this exclusive reproduction of the 1970 to 78 Camaro dash pad. Get one for your car and improve your ride. Check out National Parts Depot for Mustang and Cougar, Camaro and Firebird, Chevelle and GTO, Ford truck and Bronco, Chevy truck, Mopar, and Thunderbird. At our four locations, we stock the largest selection of classic car parts anywhere. Visit us at nationalpartsdepot.com or call us at 888-893-FAST.
Ooh, gasoline and a mirror. I know what you're thinking. You don't even have to say it. You're thinking we should be doing a video this week on springs
that we said we're going to be doing for about 3 or 4 weeks now.
It's my fault. It usually is. what had happened was...
Well, don't start that now.
We actually had promised Gina and Vince that this week we would start on the windows on their car, and I had forgotten about that. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to just do this as an interim. Dad's still at Pruitt Health in rehab. I mean, physical therapy. So we're still kind of dealing with that with him and Mom. So we're going to do something short.
Yeah, easy.
But this is also a viewer request. So we've had somebody actually write in and ask us about doing this with the mirrors, because he says he's got some very rare Buick mirrors from an early Buick, and they're floppy on the outside. So when he hits a bump, the mirror drops. Yeah. He wants to know if there's a way to tighten them up. And I've done some research, and apparently gasoline and a mirror go together-ish.
As long as there's no sparks.
Yeah, well, anyway, I'm going to go into all that in just a minute. We're going to talk to you also about these kind of mirrors as well, some of the other things you can deal with, some of the Ford product stuff that can be a problem. So I'm going to go ahead and start off with this. So let's clear that off the table, and I'll get moving on what we're doing here.
All right.
What I've got here is basically a flat blade screwdriver and a rag, and basically that's going to come into play in just a second. What I want to talk to you about first is how to separate the glass from the actual mirror itself. And there's a couple of different things you can do. Some guys have recommended lacquer thinner. I actually prefer gasoline or diesel fuel to do this, and the reason I say that is that lacquer thinner will evaporate much quicker than the gasoline or the diesel, and all three of them will do the same function. All three of them will serve to loosen the glue on the face of the mirror. And the other thing I'll say about this is also, when you do this, set it in a pail and put it outside overnight. You don't really want to have this stuff sitting inside your shop, because right now in the studio here, this is stinking up the joint. It smells pretty bad. It's gasoline and there's vapors coming off of it. And I'll say this, gasoline vapor is far more volatile and far more problematic than gasoline itself. You need to be careful of the vapors. Don't be smoking in an enclosed area when you're working on this stuff, because you will explode yourself all over the place, and you don't want to die in a fiery ball. Or a fiery ball of any kind. In any case, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to basically take this out, and I'm going to see if I can get this glass to separate. Now, this is the mirror off of our 64 Falcon, and you can see that right away, without even using my screwdriver, I was able to get it to separate. And this is basically held on with some rubber and some adhesive in these pinpoints. And the thing that you're working on next is going to be right here in the center. I'm going to set all this aside, dry it off a little bit, and take this pail of gasoline back outside where it belongs. Okay, gas has been disposed of. Now, you may be asking yourself, why am I talking about this? Well, there are certain cars that you just can't get the mirrors for them, and you may want to either A, take them apart to send them out for plating, or you may want to go in and have a good mirror and have a problem with it being super floppy, and there's going to go into that in just a second. I will also say this, there are certain styles of mirrors that there's really no point in doing this. There are reproductions available that look so close to the original, I personally wouldn't go in and get too worried about it. But the viewer that wrote in has an early Electra, and he is not able to find mirrors for. There are mirrors available, but they don't really match up because he's running a Buick, not a Chevrolet. So it's going to cause him a little bit of a problem. So I wanted to go in and show you basically how to take this apart. We've already used the gasoline. We've separated the mirror from the actual backing. 24 hours, usually your best bet on that. Now what I want to show you is this. Basically, your biggest problem with these comes on this background area right here. Now, if you were going to take and send this out for plating, you would probably have to go in and somehow figure out how to take this off of here to get this separated out. What you're going to do about the swedge in here, this may be a screw-in item. I don't really see a good way to remove the ball from the base of the mirror. There may be a way to do this, and possibly the guys who do your plating work will know how to make that happen. But you're going to have to do that in order to get this piece off. But let's just go with what the guy said he needs to do. All right, I've got a little small tapping hammer that I use for doing trim work and stuff on the cars. You could possibly use the back edge of this trim hammer, and I may try doing that. Since this one's already tight, you're probably not going to see any real difference in this. And this is just basically to show you guys kind of how you can do this to go in and tighten these up. I put two pieces of wood here so that it kind of stabilizes and gives it a place to rest. But you really want to go in and tap those areas on either side of the mirror itself. I'm going to spin it around here. Spin it around one more time to get this where it's basically more convenient for me to work on it. That's pretty good. I'm going to use this. So what you can also do is take a chisel like this, put it right close to the center ball. The other thing I've got going on here is this table is not what I would call the most stable table we have in the joint because it is plastic and it's giving underneath the mirror. If you have a good solid surface underneath here, you're not going to get the rebound problems that I'm experiencing right now with this. Now you'll notice I'm getting fairly close to the rise where this cup is on the ball for this. And I'm not doing a gorilla job on it. I'm going in and doing a couple of light taps and checking it for tension. Still getting some motion out of it, but I'm guaranteeing if you're going down the road and it's doing that, you're probably in a rollover situation and you're in an old car and you're going to die. So I wouldn't worry too much about that. But I would also probably take this and go over to my hard table to really tighten that up. This is basically just showing you how to do this. Another thing we've also heard guys doing is using Loctite, taking the ball assembly off, putting some Loctite on the back side of it here to help tighten the mirror up. I'm a little suspect of that. I really don't think it's going to work. Okay, showing you how to tighten it up. Now I'm going to show you how to put it back together. There's a couple of different ways you can do this. You can take the assembly down to a glass shop, have them use some of the special adhesives they use, or you can do like I'm going to do. You can pull your glass in, set it aside, and use some window weld ribbon sealer. Now this is what we use when we're doing glass installations on cars like Fairlanes and some of the ones that use glue and glass, later 60s Ford stuff especially. A lot of the GM stuff was already using this, but this is what I would recommend doing if you're going to do it yourself. And what I would do is just get you some of this, take you a very small piece off, wrap it around. If you have these kind of rubber studs in here, these are basically anti-vibration points. Doesn't require a lot of this, so you could still use it to do a window if you wanted to down the road. I'm going to try doing this, placing it on the metal. And then what you want to do is place this in and work it into place. Now, when you're putting pressure on the mirror, try to put pressure only on the points where the weather strip adhesive is going to sit. Don't place any pressure in the center of your mirror because there is nothing in the center of this particular mirror for it to pressure to. You can't actually crack the glass. So I'm pressing this thing back into play. Do that. Now, I'm going to pull all this stuff out of the way. I'm going to come in here and we're going to talk about swedged mirrors from the Ford line. Out of the door! Now, the next mirror I'm talking about are these style mirrors that were used on some of the early Fords and Chevrolets. And it's got a chrome back on it with a mirror in the center. And I believe, in theory, that this one is swedged in. Now, there's a couple of ways you can do it. You can use a pair of these type of pliers that I've got right here. Preferable, though, would be a pair of end snips like this to take the swedging loose from the bottom edge of the mirror. You may still have to do the gasoline technique. There may, in fact, be some adhesive on the back of this like there is on the outside mirrors on these cars. More to fact, though, is it really worth doing it on this particular mirror? Oddly enough, on Gene and Vince's car, this is probably the nicest part of the entire car. But, in fact, this mirror is kind of schmutzy and a little rusty in places and absolutely available in the aftermarket for a very reasonable price. Much cheaper than going in and trying to go in and replace the glass and clean everything up and send it out for plating. If you're in a case with a mirror like this and you can't get the mirror for whatever reason, maybe you're working on an Oldsmobile or something weird, I don't mean that in a bad way, but weird as in aftermarket parts availability, you may have to do that. Now what you'll want to do with the swedging and what you're trying to do to stay away from is going in and hitting the mirror itself. You want to stay on top of the metal and use the pliers to pull down on the metal here. Because we could get to a point where we're pulling this loose and find out that this is actually not a swedged mirror. Because it doesn't appear to be coming out with us having pulled the swedging down on it. So I have a feeling that there's probably adhesive on the back of this. Same procedure would apply. After you've pulled the swedging back off that lower edge, take it and put it in some gasoline overnight and then see if the mirror will come loose from there. Don't go in and automatically start gorillaing up on this and trying to go in and use a screwdriver to pry it out. Use other methods first, something that's going to be less invasive because you may end up finding that it's just not going to work. Okay, and now I'm bringing my wood back in here. I'm going to set this on here and I'm going to use this wood here to bring that back in to position. See, it's bringing that swedge back into play. The reason I'm using the wood is mildly sacrificial and it's going to be less likely to break up that mirror. I'm going to do a light tap with my trim hammer. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you another mirror that Ford used in a lot of their cars, particularly 1964 5 Falcon, 1968, pretty much anything passenger car Ford seemed to have this mirror in it. I'm going to take and pull the Falcon out so you can take a look at how to make that one a little less floppity. Okay, now I've got the Falcon here. This style of stalk that Ford used was used a lot in the 1960s, all the way up through 1968. Ford used this setup on the Falcons, 1964 and 5 that I know of, and on the 68 Ford product line. Galaxies, Mustang had this in 68. And while it's an interesting solution to the problem, you have a set screw here and a set screw on the backside that you guys can't see. One of the first things you want to try when you're working on one of these is to just go in, oddly enough, and, tighten the screws, because sometimes that's enough to make it work correctly. You have to be really careful to not over tighten them though, because when you do, you can actually cause this to bow out and create yourself a problem. See, that one was completely loose. Now that's one solution to the problem. What if it won't tighten up? I'm going to show you another way to go in and possibly get that mirror to tighten up so it doesn't flop all around while you're driving trying to look at that car back behind you. All right, a solution to the problem of one of these mirrors being extremely loose is, oddly enough, our friend tinfoil. We've used this in the last few episodes, and it looks like we have a sponsorship by Reynolds Wrap, but we really don't. Tinfoil just comes in handy on stuff like this because it makes a good shim on the mirror. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this one down and out. And a lot of times you have to take the set screws all the way out of them and drop them on the floor because that's what we do around here. There. Now you see I've got this one here. This is basically coming off of the ball assembly. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this aside for a moment and show you what I've got up here because it's going to be a little easier for my camera crew to see it. I'm going to take and tear off a small piece of aluminum foil. And I'm going to take and put it on the ball. Sometimes you may need to do two applications of it. I'll get this one started so it'll stay put. I'm going to put a little piece of tin foil on the other end. And what I'll want to do is after I get the tin foil on here and put it back in place is I'll cut that tin foil out around the ball. All right, there you go. Good tension on the mirror. And the nice thing about this is it's going to stay there because you got that shim in there with the aluminum foil, and the aluminum foil gives it a little bit more grip than it would have normally. Well, that's our show for this week, folks. Next, we're gonna be coming back with how to set up the window regulators in a 1965-66 Mustang. And so after that, we're probably gonna go in and actually do something with our 69 Fairlane and the springs, at least in theory. So do us a favor and come back and watch us next Thursday on Autorestomod. Have a great week, folks. I wonder what Cam's doing. Probably nothing. Do that scene. This is a retake of the scene with the mirror.